We will all offer the prayer of meditation. Father of blessings, with that unlimited love, may we receive salvation on this earth. May all things be prosperous. To those who love, that unlimited material blessings may we receive. And when we go out, may become blessings. And may our children do more well with those blessings. And may we be patriots to our country and our people. And for world peace, may we live as ambassadors of Christ with love. In Jesus' name, we thank you and bless. Amen. Please repeat after me. We will do more well. As much as you love God, you receive love. That's Proverbs chapter 8, verse 17. So if you keep loving, when those spider webs, they keep getting stacked up, that's when you can even lift up a car. But with one spider web, you can't do anything. So it's as much as you love. That's how you will surely do well. So those people who keep doing this, they'll know more and more. So when we sin and we don't repent and we're stubborn, then the sins get stored up. And when that disaster explodes, you know, your country and the country is ruined. But if you store up blessings, it's the same thing. But it's because you're not loving properly. That's where you make problems. So this love is to go to heaven. It's not with your head like a dog pig, with your soul like a beast. It's not that love. James chapter 3, verse 15 to 16. Let's find 3 John verse 2. So you keep thinking that it's beastly love, that's a man's love. But beastly love is the worst of evil. It's when you have demons. That's James chapter 3, verse 15 and 16. So which love is it? It's the love of the heart. The love of the heart is what God gives. So a lot of people talk about love, but other than God, there is no love. It's all demons. It's all evil. So as much as you receive God's love, you're able to love others, and that's the commandment. So 3 John verse 2, it says it's those who love that this applies to. But people take this away and they just say, oh, your spirit soul that prospers. And so it's all lies. So love is the greatest. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 13. But what is love? John chapter 1 verse 1. The word is love, because this word is God. So the word is love. So they talk about love, but if you're writing it down, how can that be love? It's all lies. And yet they're essentially thinking that is love. It's as much as you have the word that you have love. Why? The word, John chapter 1 verse 1, the word is God. And God, 1 John chapter 4 verse 8, is love. So as much as you have the word, you have love. So the mystery of God, this word comes by the mystery of God, forced their repentance. So someone who has God's love, you have to at least have the love that is wisdom. And in 1 Kings chapter 4, you have to at least repent of 5,000 verses where you don't have to write it down, where the word is so clear. That is God's love. That is the love that goes to heaven. But to not know this, and you have to write down a few things, you know, that's not love. That's lies. And then they're talking about love, you know, thoughtlessly. So it's so amongst all these faiths, still, Korea, we have been given this blessing. So how thankful is this? When you go out, 10,000 things, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 10, is connected with money. 10,000 things are related to money. Even if you repent of 5,000 things, you're able to go to heaven, your spirit soul does well. But if you want to be victorious over 10,000 things, it's as much as you love God that you love your neighbor and you're given money. That's Proverbs chapter 8, verse 21. So when you go out in your lives, if you want 10,000 things to do well, all things to do well and to be victorious, you need to have this love. And that's why 3 John verse 2, it says, it starts by saying beloved. Let's read together and may this become our food. Beloved, I pray that in all respects you may prosper and be in good health, just as your soul prospers. Amen. So firstly, it says here, beloved. Love, other than God, there is no love. Why? Because it's God isn't two. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 3 to 6, if you read, God is one. Someone who's received the Holy Spirit is one. So if you have received the Holy Spirit, you are, there's no difference, but we're one. But you know what's strange about Korea? They say they have love, that they've received the Holy Spirit, and yet they say us and you. That's a lie. And that's why Jude chapter 1, verse 19, if you say you love and yet you have denominations and factions, Jude chapter 1, verse 19, you're of the flesh, and surely you will go to hell. Because you're of the flesh, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 3, everywhere you go, you argue and you nitpick. And those people haven't received the Holy Spirit, they have demons. That's what's recorded there. And yet you make these denominations, my denomination, your denomination. And then, you know, Korea, we're still lying and say we have the Holy Spirit. It's here, it's, that means you're not included in this beloved. So who is it that loves? Well, it's only God who is love. 1 John chapter 4, verse 8. Other than that, it's all dog pig love, which is of the IQ, the soul. Even dog pigs love each other. But that's beastly love. It's not the love of a man. So if you love with your head, that's a dog pig. It's only love of the heart that is God's love. So it's, soon we'll be talking about that. So here it says, beloved. If you truly loved properly, if God is love, well, God's word is love. Because this word is God, John chapter 1, verse 1. So if you have one Bible verse, let's say that's one spider web, with that, nothing works out. So how much do you need to have love? Well, the love where you receive the wisdom and knowledge, wisdom and understanding to go to heaven. So how much is that? About 5,000 verses, more than 4,005, 1 Kings chapter 4. So if you've repented and put that word in your heart, that is faith. John chapter 5, verse 8. Memorizing the Bible with your head, that's demons. You kill yourself. That's not faith. So if you memorize it with your head, Proverbs chapter 26, verse 9, you kill yourself. You become someone who's crazy. So if you go to these mental hospitals, it's filled with people who have memorized the Bible and they've become crazy. And so now they're afraid. And so they don't memorize it and they write it down, but that's not love. You need to have as much of the word inside of you so you can go to heaven. And that happens by repentance. When does the word come inside of you? It's when you repent by Christ, by the mystery of God. Christ first has to come with you. Christ and Jesus are one. That's when the word comes inside of you. John chapter 5, verse 38, and that is faith. And that faith is love. So as much as you have the numbers of the word, that's how much love you have. So in all this word, where do they eat as much of the word as here in Busan First Church? You know, already there's been so many Bible verses that have been given out. So if you only know a few things and you have to write it down, that's not love. And if you're making denominations and factions, that's even more not love, because there is only one love. So he's giving us this good promise today. So if your spirit soul does well, and you're going to heaven, that's what's recorded here. So if you're loving correctly, properly, then your soul spirit does well, so you're going to heaven. So that means all things, 10,000 things, will do well. You'll even be given health. So I have to surely receive this, and my children have to receive this. Is this amen? Because we have to go to heaven. So we have to receive these blessings. So if we receive these blessings, if our soul spirit does well, so that everything does well, and we receive health, well, there is a condition, and that is love. That's what God has said. So for our soul spirit to do well, for everything to do well, to have health, as long as your soul spirit does well, as long as you love, then this will happen. Is this amen? Let's read it again. So it's to those who are beloved that this promise applies. But you don't even know what love is, and you attend church and you just memorize this, and that's why you go to hell. Your children don't do well, you don't do well. If you want to become someone who is beloved, if you want to be able to share God's love with others, well, this love is to keep the commandment. If you keep the commandment, then you don't have denominations. You know, if you knew how good this was, there'd be so many people who join this to do the best work of a man. That's why we're here. And not just me, but my children, to live most preciously, to live most rightly, for me to have blessings in my late age, for my children to do well, to live as righteous so that our name remains forever. That's why we're here. So those people who know this, what this is, how precious this is. But if we could make denominations, but if we do, 100% we'll go to hell. But it's these beasts who don't know this, and they talk about God's love carelessly. That's dog pig love. This word is love because this word is God. But God is in Christ, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19. So without the mystery of Christ, the mystery of God, and you say you love God, that's all, it's all lies. So now don't be deceived by your own self, but for me to live, to have blessings in my late age, to go to heaven. If your soul spirit does well, you'll go to heaven. So may we all receive these blessings. So we don't have time to read this again, but beloved. So this is the condition. If your love is right, then where will you go? You'll go to heaven, and all things will do well, and you'll even be given health. So then your children, 1,000 generations, will do well. That's his promise. So God is, so this love is God, and this word is God. So as much as you have the Bible, the amount of the Bible, that's how much you have love. But if someone's standing in front of you having to look at the Bible verses, you know, how much love do you think they have? So you need to discern. So when it says beloved, this love, Mark chapter 12, verse 30 to 31, it's to keep the commandment. So if you keep the commandment, so someone who's beloved, firstly, they go to heaven. Their soul spirit does well. So if my spirit and soul does well, then I have to go to heaven. Let's find Proverbs chapter 19, verse 16. Let's see. Let's check to see if this word is correct. So you say you love God, but God's love, with just a few things, you can't receive salvation. And that's why to have more than 4,005 verses, to repent of 5,000 verses, you've got to be someone who's eating that. It's only that person that can say this, the sermon of wisdom that will take you to heaven. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20, Psalms chapter 49, verse 3. That is the true pastor that God acknowledges, the man of understanding. But those people who don't even know what understanding is, how can they have love? Why is it Korea is a country where we lie so shamelessly? Before, you and I in our past, we were deceived by that. So we have to repent of this. Let's read together. He who keeps the commandment keeps his soul, but he who is careless of conduct will die. Amen. So it's only someone who keeps the commandment. What happens to their spirit soul? Because they keep it, they receive salvation. They'll go to heaven. But if you don't keep the commandment, you'll go to hell. But if you keep the commandment, you'll go to heaven. So what is the commandment? Mark chapter 12, verse 30 to 31. First of all, to love God, and second, to love your neighbor. But someone who hasn't received God's love, they pretend to love others double-mindedly, but they don't love. That's 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 22. So if you don't even love others and yet you pretend to, that person always loves to boast of their name. So there's only one thing we should boast of. Galatians chapter 6, verse 14. Lord, Jesus, Christ and the cross. But they don't boast of the Lord Jesus Christ and the cross. So they're all boasting of themselves. So outside of the Lord is demons. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 30. But if you speak in the Lord, that's boasting of the Lord. It may be the same testimony, but if you do four-step repentance and you're in Christ, where Christ changes to become the Lord who helps me after I repent of my sins and my ancestors' sins and he helps me, that's someone who boasts of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. No matter how much they boast, they're not boasting of themselves. But otherwise, all other boastings is boasting of yourself. Because you boast of yourself, if you look at that person, God, he smashes them. You'll see it clearly with your eyes. Psalms 112, verse 8. Their lives will end so cursedly. Their children will end cursedly. Let's go to heaven. By doing what? By keeping the commandment. Where our spirit soul does well. By keeping the commandment. So here it's talking about loving your neighbor. First, you love God with your heart and all your life, with all your will and strength. But because you can't do this, you don't have God's love. Because you haven't received God's love, that's why you can't love your neighbor. So that's why people like these fake churches where they don't love their neighbor. If you don't love your neighbor, there's no salvation. You're going to hell, but that's what the faith do. What about you? If you hate to come here, then already you have demons inside of you. You're a fake. That person, they have disease inside of them because they can't receive salvation. Then all things are filled with problems because they're like that. Then the children are going the way of ruin, so they don't do well. So today we've come to be released of this. We've come to fix our destiny. Is this amen? Is this amen? So beloved, the beloved, the word that they repent. So when you receive the gift of Christ, you need to be abounding in the word of Christ of four-step repentance. It has to be more than 5,000. That's what God has appointed, Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So someone who's repented of 5,000 things, why would they be a fake and write it down? How is it that you make these walls saying, this is my neighborhood, your neighborhood, going to hell? They have demons, and yet they talk with their mouths about the Holy Spirit. What lies they are. So let's live. So for our spirit soul to do well, it's to first love God and then to love your neighbor. In front of God, you have to give up your hearts and then your lives. Because it's not my life from the beginning. If it was your life, why is it that at a young age on your way to your honeymoon you die? Or you die after having one child? Or you die after having two children? They say, you know, it's where things become worse. You know, you don't do well in this and you don't do well that. You do doubly, you know, worse. It comes out on the news sometimes. It's because there's no love there. Because you've got that heredity from your ancestors where they do filthy things, and that's why you're not being released. What's the way to release this? If you love God properly, someone who's received love, the fruits are that they love their neighbor. So if you love your neighbor, Proverbs chapter 8, verse 21, then you're given money, everything, because everything's related to money. If you're released from money, then you receive everything. That's the blessing we've come for me, my children. This is the blessing we've come for. So why are your money problems not being solved? Because you're the worst of evil. You've got nothing but this head love, beastly love. You don't have the love of a man. And how is this shown? If you truly are a pastor that loves your neighbor, if you truly are a saint that loves your neighbor, well, let's examine to see if you're right according to this word. Let's find 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 22. So if you don't keep the commandment, and you say you, me, you know, and you make denominations, factions saying just us, that's not a man. You don't have the Holy Spirit, so you have demons. So you're always nitpicking, arguing. It's a sign that you're a beast. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 3. What about the sign of love. If you truly love God properly and you have love for your neighbor, then your spirit soul does well, all things do well, and you have health. Well, what kind of love then do we need? Let's read 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 22. Since you have in obedience to the truth purified your souls for a sincere love of the brethren, fervently love one another from the heart. Amen. So it's, what do you love with? It's not the head love of a dog pig with your IQ, with your soul, with worldly learning. That love is all dog pig, beastly love. It's only the love of from the heart that is the love of a man. So if you have this love from the heart, then you love each other. Then you don't love with a dog pig. So if you have God's love, if that love comes to me, then your diseases are healed. Then all things are released. You need that love to go to heaven. And with that love, you can love your neighbor. You need to have that love so that your family, all gatherings, you become one. So there's nothing but God's love. But it says here, fervently love one another from the heart. But if you try to give your love, you can see they're beasts that are perishing, dog pigs. So if you love that dog pig, then you're crazy. So if you can't even discern, then you're in beastly love. So your soul's not being, your spirit's not being saved. All things aren't doing well. And so today, everything you meet, it's not doing well. So that's a problem. It's because you don't have God's love. You can see by how you love your neighbor. So like a dog pig, if you just love anyone, then you're a fake. But if you firmly love one another from the heart, that's only the person who is, that's the only person who is true. It's not that you're a pastor that you have love. If you make denominations and factions, do you have love or not? So if there's no love there, why do you say that's love? If there are denominations and factions, they don't have the Holy Spirit love. But they're demons, Jude chapter 1, verse 19. So how can there be love? And those without love, all of the word it has an address. That's Proverbs chapter 8, verse 12. So if you don't even have the Bible verse, the address, what chapter or verse, you know, how can you say you have God's love? So if you truly fervently love your neighbor from the heart, if you want to receive even money blessings, if you want to receive blessings where your children do well, first of all, you have to obey the truth. What is the truth? John chapter 17, verse 17. It's the word. It's God. So you have to obey this word. But you don't even obey the mystery of God. If you make denominations, factions, then you don't follow the truth. Romans chapter 2, verse 8. So if you're not even obeying the truth, how can you have love? So now we have to stop saying these lies. So you can't be deceived by yourself. And then you say you're not doing well, that you're not going to receive salvation. Well, no, because your spirit soul's not doing well. You have to obey the truth. So what is this obedience? You think you can obey by your own accord? You have to receive the Holy Spirit to cast out demons, and then a long time after, you can obey. So to obey the truth, to obey according to this word. So which word do we disobey? Even if you take away one Bible verse, it will be hell. That's Revelation chapter 22, verse 19. But then you take away all the important things from the Bible. How can that be obeying the truth? But that's how you've lived thus far. Firstly, to keep the commandment, to fervently love one another from the heart, where if you want to have your spirit soul saved, you need to have this love. So the truth, the 66 books of the Bible, Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life, John chapter 14, verse 6. What is the truth? It is the word, John chapter 17, verse 17. So whatever of the word, if it says the mystery of God, you should say amen and obey. But people don't even talk about the mystery of God. They don't acknowledge it. And more so, You know, there are people who are lying and doing, taking away the fourth and fourth state repentance. And how can that be obeying the truth? It's God who appointed a quarter, a quarter, a quarter. It's not something we made up. So to do these things where your spirit soul will go to hell, and then how can you expect to do well? How can you receive the blessings of health? How can you receive the blessings of money? You know, and take the money blessings in front of you, Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15. So if you want to be victorious, you have to obey the truth. But it's not something that I can do. You say, I'm going to. You know, there are a lot of people at church who want to be ruined. They say, I'm going to do it so that I'll do well. Then you'll continue to receive difficult problems and you'll just be ruined. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 9. Why do things by your strength? If you could, then I wouldn't be able to say anyone can do well. God wouldn't say it either. But God says anyone, as long as you're in Christ, you're a new creation. He will make you anew. Because it's God himself who will do it. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. So anyone can do well. Let's all receive this blessing. Is this amen? It's so precious. So it's by first obeying the truth. But if you take away, you know, everything from the Bible and then you just, you know, just use a few Bible verses, is that obeying the truth? And then they're asking for death and you eat that food, unless you want to die with them, how can you eat that? So starting from you have to obey the truth. That's when your spirit soul, what happens to it? It becomes clean. So if you can't even purify your own spirit soul, if you want your spirit soul to be purified, you need the truth. The truth is all of the 66 books of the Bible. So to at least go to heaven, you need to at least be eating 5,000 verses all the time, not memorizing, but with your heart, so that you have a great faith. Why would you need to be writing it down? Someone who knows all of Busan, why would they have to write down a map? So it's only someone who's doing this, someone who makes their spirit soul purified, can they truly love their neighbor as themselves. That person will receive blessings. So loving my neighbor, let's see if I'm truly doing this. Let's read verse 22 again. Since you have in obedience to the truth purified your souls for a sincere love of the brethren, fervently love one another from the heart. Amen. So if I just wrote down a few things and I came out, is that love? Is that love? The love that goes to heaven, at least, this is what God says, at least you have more than 4,005 verses. So for us to be assured of going to heaven, we have to at least do 5,000 verses. So this word, this word of repentance, you know, do you have the same nutrition from a few anchovies or you know, 5,000 anchovies in? So you have to first obey the truth. You need to have this word that you have repented in your heart, more than 5,000. And so Christ has been your heart, and Christ and Jesus are one. So Jesus has been your heart, and that is faith. John chapter 5, verse 38. If you don't have this faith, those people who only have a few of the word, they're crazy to kill Jesus. John chapter 8, verse 47. Those people where the word doesn't go into their hearts, even now they're trying to kill Jesus. So Jesus, the number of the word to go inside of us as faith. But these people, these crazy people where the word doesn't go into their hearts, they're crazy. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 3. If the word doesn't go into your heart, you're not of your right mind. You're crazy. So which blessing do you want to receive today? In this new year, how is it we have to live? Have I obeyed the truth or not? Are you obeying the 66 books of the Bible or not? You think that you can obey of your own accord? You can't. You think that you can eat this word of truth of your own accord? According to God's word, you have to do the mystery of God, four-step repentance. So the way for your spirit soul to do well, to go to heaven, unless you keep the commandment, you cannot go to heaven. So in order to keep the commandment, firstly, you have to love God, and then you have to love your neighbor. So as much as you love God, Proverbs chapter 8, verse 17, you receive love. And that love goes out as love for your neighbor. So that person, the way they love their husband or wife is different. They don't love according to their mood. They just unconditionally just love them. It's so good. So it's only the righteous who have happiness. So if you go to a bathhouse, if you just wash two or three fingers and then you say, oh, I'm clean, I'm righteous. You know, if you just splash around in water, if anything, you'll get water streaks. So just with a few verses, you can't have love. If someone has to write down a few Bible verses, has it gone into their head or in their heart? If it's in your heart, why would you need to write down? It's because it's in your head, your demons. That's why you have to write down. So if your spirit soul's not doing well, you go to hell and all things don't work out. So if I'm like that, then Exodus chapter 20, verse 5 and 6, then I kill 3 and 4 generations. So you see these grandchildren not doing well, and yet you're doing that so shamelessly. There is so many money blessings in front of you. Why can't you take them when he's put them there? Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15, you don't have love. So the condition is that you first love. That's when your spirit soul does well, everything does well, and you have health. That's when your children do well. So why is it you choose the things not to do well? At this time, for me to not do, I'm not doing well, my children aren't doing well, I don't have health, all things aren't doing well. Is that why you're here? And to be a fake and pretend, you know, that you're not like that. You know, you've only got a few Bible verses. Even if you take one Bible verse away, you'll go to hell. But you've taken all of it away and you just have this few. You know, one rice grain is still rice. What, to eat 2 or 3 grains and then how long do you think you're going to live? Why do that? And then what, you talk about love? The word is love. You know, rice grains is rice. But if you're only fed 5 or 6 grains, then you'll die. So how can you do well with just a few Bible verses? How can that be love? So it's not the love of the heart. So if the word doesn't go into your heart, and like a demon, you memorize it, because you memorize it, that's why you have to write it down. And those people, even now, they're trying to kill Jesus. And that's why they'll curse you who believe. And they'll go the way where they and their children are ruined, destroyed. Let's find John chapter 8, verse 37. If the word doesn't go into your heart, let's see whether or not you become someone who tries to kill Jesus. So all night long, I was made to meditate something else. But when I came here, he gives me this. I don't know. I just do whatever the Father tells me to. If I write it down and I do it, 100% that's a demon. If you do things by your strength, you have nothing to do with God. Let's read together. John chapter 8, verse 37. I know that you are Abraham's descendants, yet you seek to kill me because my word has no place in you. Amen. So is Jesus dead and gone, or is he still living? He's still living and here. So him coming inside of me, that is faith. But if that word doesn't go into your heart, then you end up trying to kill Jesus. That's what God has recorded. So you who believe in Jesus properly, demons, they say all sorts of curses. But are you going to fall and go to hell? Let's go to heaven. As long as our spirit soul does well, as long as you have love, if your spirit soul does well, then all things do well. And 10,000 generations do well. We all have to receive this blessing. That's why we're here. It's glory to God. It's truly, you know, let's do more well. Let's call upon the Lord three times for our spirit soul to do well. And with God's love, if we love, then all blessings, money blessings will be poured out. Have a look. As much as you love God, what happens? As much as you love God, you know, what happens to you and your children? You know, your child will be like this. You know, this year I'm doing well. And it's because of this. So according to this word, if you receive God's love, and so without four-step repentance, how can you make your spirit soul clean? Without the mystery of God, you can't. But these people who don't even do four-step repentance and they say, oh, we love each other, our church is love. It's all lies. Why be deceived by that? How is it that you can just leave them alone? If you love your neighbor, you'll say, that's a lie. Let's not become someone who loves with lies, but to truly love. How many lies are there that God's recorded this? So it's to love with your heart. It's as much as the words in your heart that you have love. It's not the lies where you memorize it. Let's do well. So according to this word, to first repent so that Christ comes into my heart. And it's that repented word, that's Jesus. And that word comes in as faith. And then when we repent of our sins and our ancestors' sins, that word becomes the word of the Lord, where it helps us. So from, let's realize correctly, from today, it's a new start. Without a past, we don't have a past. In Christ, it's a new start. Let's call upon the Lord three times. Lord, Lord, Lord. For me to do well, my children to do well, in all things to do well. May we all receive this blessing.